Hello, my name's Dan Sager. I work for the UK importers of Interphone, motorcycle communication systems. And today I'm going to show you how to fit an Interphone F3 system to a motorcycle helmet. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to pair up two of these communication units so they're effectively talking to each other. This button here is the main operating button, and you simply hold that button down on both units until the little LED light is flashing blue, then red, alternately. And when it's flashing blue, then red, that means it's in communication mode, and that means they're ready to talk to each other. When it's done that, you press the button on one of the units one time, and then they should start flashing. And when they stop flashing and they go to solid blue, that means that they're paired up with each other, they can find each other, and they're ready to talk. Just like using a Bluetooth headset with your mobile telephone. It takes a few seconds to do, so don't panic if they don't do it immediately. It will happen. Bear in mind that they've got to find the other unit and lock in. Okay, now both units are showing solid blue. You're ready to go. You're ready to talk to each other using the units. So, fitting the bracket using the 3M adhesive strip, which is exceptionally strong. It's always a good idea just to give the area you're going to fix it to a wipe with a dry, soft cloth. You can't beat a spotted handkerchief. And peel off the adhesive strip. Now, we're going to fit the bracket to the left side of the helmet. And that's nothing to do with being left or right-handed. It's because you need the right hand to control the motorcycle through the throttle. So once you've found a good spot to stick it to, remove the adhesive backing, pop the bracket on, and it's firmly in place. Then just smooth it down with a soft cloth again, just to make sure everything's bonding nicely, and job's done. With the bracket in place, fitting the unit is simplicity itself. It simply clips over through two lugs, and clunk, it's in place. It's dead solid, nothing's going to move it. It's completely waterproof. Don't have to worry about getting caught in a rain shower. And to remove it, you just press down that button there, and off it comes. Job done. Fitting the headset can often seem quite daunting to people because it involves messing around with helmet linings and things like that. But don't worry, you don't need to chisel out parts of the lining, you don't need to rip out anything. It can all be done very simply using the design of the helmet lining. The first thing to do is to figure out where the earphone needs to go. The best thing to do is to look for the slight hole or cavity around the ears in the helmet lining, which you can probably see just in there. What I'm going to do is just remove the cheek pad, and on most modern helmets the cheek pads are removable. That pops off. We put the earpiece inside the cavity. Now remember that the side with the boom microphone on it needs to be on the side of the helmet which takes the communication unit. It's all pretty obvious when you're putting it together. And with that in place, we then need to pop the cheek pad back in. Making sure that you line up all the poppers correctly, it all clicks neatly back into place. For the other earphone, there's plenty of cable and you just feed it in, tucking it neatly out of the way around the neck curtain in the case of this helmet. And then on the other side, once you get round to the other side, you simply have to pop out the cheek pad again and pop it inside the ear cavity. Now obviously, when you're doing this at home, you've got a bit of time to play around. You can locate everything really neatly and get all the slack wire out of the way. This is just a general guide to show you how it's all done. With everything in place, you've then got the boom microphone, which you can position neatly over your mouth. And the final job is to connect the communication unit to the headphone and microphone, which goes through this waterproof connector in here and just plugs neatly into place. Turning off the unit couldn't be more simple. Using the big button again, simply keep it pressed down until the light flashes. Once the red light starts flashing, it's going to turn itself off. Recharging. Battery charger is provided with the unit, and it simply recharges from your normal household socket. Nothing complicated there, it's got an internal battery. Again, very similar to a mobile telephone. The unit is completely waterproof. You'll see that there are volume switches to take the volume down or to take the volume up on the side of the unit. It's easy to use with a gloved hand, no problem there at all. And if your telephone rings while you're riding the bike and you want to answer the call, simply press the button on the side of the helmet and that will enable you to answer the call. When you wish to end the call, simply press the button again. So you've really only got that one button to worry about for operating the system and the volume switch on the side. Nothing more fiddly than that. So, I hope that's told you something about the Interphone F3 unit and how it works. There's plenty more information available on the UK website. And if you've got any questions, feel free to email us and we'll answer you back.